crazy. I like that, you like that, so let's be crazy. The contact, impact, I want that daily. Our breath getting deeper, deeper lately. I like that, baby, 'cause I can't get enough.
Dice que no le es suficiente, está mal de la mente. Cuando está solita que entre, música para ponerla en ambiente, yeah. Ella quiere que coma aquella bella, le busco todo. Todo lo que se pone bonito se le ve. Empezamos a pie y ahora andamos en el che. Vamos a calentar, baby, tú. No se quiere olvidar, lo quiere recordar, baby.
'Cause I can't get enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
Latino can.
Yeah, I can't get enough of your love. Give me some more of it. I can't get enough.
Come on.
Yeah. 'Cause I can't crazy. I like that. You like that. So let's be crazy. The contact, impact, I want that daily. Our breath getting deeper, deeper lately. I like that, baby, yeah. Ooh, no one's gotta know, we can keep it low-key. I'll be fine alone, long as you're alone with me.
Tell him.
So
K TV swag in the park. You guys are looking good. I know I need some 2K TV swag.
Yes, and you can get that by answering 2K TV interactive questions in the game every single week for that exclusive gear. It's been really cool to see fans out there repping all the 2K TV stuff, so keep doing it.
Here's a look at some of the outfits you guys submitted using the hashtag 2K TV swag. Keep them coming, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA. It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Greetings, everyone. Our game tonight featuring the New York Knicks as they go up against the Boston Celtics in Boston. Well, for Boston, this is a team they played pretty well against last season, going 3-1. They'll look to keep that edge tonight. And here we are. Game one of the new season. Kenny, every team coming in with a clean slate.
Yeah, because whatever you had troubles in last year, that doesn't matter. This is a new year. Be optimistic until proven otherwise.
I'm just looking forward to spending another year with you guys. It's family. And Ernie, you're looking 10 years younger.
Thank you so much. I'm feeling 10 years younger as well.
Man. It's all exercise.
And you're looking like, what are you? You're down to, what, 275?
No, 575.
575.
Lost 15 pounds.
Wow. Unbelievable.
I grew some hair.
Did you? Yeah, you did.
That's a wig.
All right. Y'all still there? Good.
Miss you later. Guys too.
The Celtics strutting through the tunnel earlier on. The Boston faithful waiting to cheer them on as they get set to take the floor. And the game arrival, sponsored by Express. Dress like a pro. A terrific evening look at Old Town Bear. The historic city of Boston is our backdrop tonight. Welcome, everybody, to the day we've all been looking forward to. The start of a new NBA season on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, this is Kevin Harlan. We'll be hearing from David Aldridge on the sideline. Hey, Dave.
Guys, Celtics coach Brad Stevens is known for his play calling. LeBron James said he has so many different wrinkles. You've got to keep your head on a swivel. He'll run something you've never seen before. But Stevens said, honest to God, I've stolen everything we've ever done from somebody else. Kevin?
I love his honesty. All right, thank you, D.A. A chance now to check out the Knicks' upcoming schedule. On Wednesday, the Atlanta Hawks come to town. That will tip off a homestand for them. Then on Friday, they'll be facing Drew Holiday and the New Orleans Pelicans. So the New York starting five, Barrett and Knox are the wingmen. It's Randall and Robinson at the four and the five. And it's Smith in at the point. And for Boston, Tatum and Cantor together down low. Brown and Hayward, they're the wing. And it's Walker in at the point guard. And the Celtics rebounding well this summer. From the loss of Kyrie Irving and Al Horford, Kemba Walker possibly a better fit for this team.
And with their young core, understandable that they didn't want to extend Horford out to age 37. A revamped roster, but I think they remain a contender in the East. Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack, and where's the help defensively?
Are you asking me, G.A.? I'm not sure.
The shot's good from Smith.
Showing some imagination that time on offense. Smith Jr. mixing it up with the defenders.
Here's Walker. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
And hitting the mid-range jumper here early gives the defense just another thing to think about.
Yeah, he's got to be a little bit more on their radar after knocking down something like that.
Drops in the breakaway layup. Walker's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Well, a good start here. That's Trey for Trey, and that's Spanish for three.
You're right. And Enes Kanter picks up the foul. Enes. That is his first foul of the game.
That's his first personal foul.
First quarter of play, 1 minute played. Smith the pass to Robinson. That three off the mark.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
Here's Tatum. Look at that.
Tell you what, don't sleep on Tatum. He has some ups. And I love seeing him trying to electrify the crowd.
And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for New York. 6-point game. Pass to Randall. Smith outside. Shoots the three. New York, no good that time either.
Oh, man, you know he'd love to have that one over.
And it's Walker penetrating. Down it goes for his third basket in as many tries.
Man, they're making everything and look confident. Five shots, five makes.
Smith, and oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. And you spend any amount of time watching Dennis Smith Jr., Greg, his leaping ability makes for some impressive highlights.
Kevin, he's got the size and the off-the-charts athleticism. Now just trying to figure out how to realize his obvious potential.
And he knocks down the first one. Opening night, Brent, always exciting. Technically, every team is undefeated with a lot of hope.
You're just fired up. I mean, I am fired up. The NBA never stops, Kevin. We know this, right?
Isn't it great, though? I'm so glad it doesn't stop.
The offseason is just absolutely ridiculously exciting.
So fun.
So much movement and hope for franchises that, have struggled for a long time. And here we go. Hope springs eternal. It's opening night.
Well, the big story from the Knicks last season was the surprise trade that sent Porzingis to Dallas. shook up the entire roster.
Well, never easy to trade a franchise player, but there was some rumblings that maybe Porzingis was not going to stay there long term. And a surprise deal made last year as Porzingis exited New York for Dallas. So the next opportunity for them was draft and free agency and to try to get as flexible as they possibly could be for the next few years.
Here's Smith. Jason Tatum picking up that last basket. And Brown over to help. Barrett kicks to Smith. And no good. Now the Celtics take it the other way. And this matchup with the Knicks, hard to believe, just the first game of the NBA's 82-game regular season.
And they didn't have much of a problem with these guys last season, and quite frankly, you wouldn't expect them to.
Here's Smith. After Gordon Hayward's bucket, Walker with some nice D.
Is it getting cold in here, Kevin? This is a tough one. Crucial that he starts to work a little harder for a higher percentage shot.
And it's out of bounds. The Knicks will take it the other way. First quarter of play. We're about 3 minutes in. Smith, the pass to Robinson. Here's Knox. And that's good. Robinson picking up the assists.
Like it when you fire it to a teammate who's ready to shoot, and Kevin Knox was.
Here's Brown, and easy 2 points on the layup.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Out to the wing. Barrett, wide open, he fires. No good with the wing jumper. And Walker's got the ball here for the Celtics. They're leading by 8. And it's Brown missing. New York's gone 2-4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Here's Barrett, and it's blocked by Brown, and they're able to recover. They retain possession. Boston. Out of bounds, Boston takes possession. Celtics leading by 8. There's Walker with the 3. Connects from 3-point range. Walker's got 9.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
To the inside. Smith with the basket on the assist by Barrett. 6 points for Smith.
How about that for some confidence? Dennis Smith Jr. isn't afraid of trying his luck on the inside.
And Kevin Knox gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. Walker against Smith. Shot's good by Walker. 11 points in the game.
As hot as he's been this quarter, the game plan is simple, folks. Get him the ball and get out of the way.
Smith dishes to Robinson. Back to Smith. Beyond the arc. And Boston with the rebound. Williams finds Tatum. And that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession.
All right, a chance to look at the numbers now for Walker. Last season, he played outstanding, 10th in scoring, and he also finished in the top 20 of the assist rankings, making plays for others and making his teammates better.
And back to his points per game average last year, he literally propped up the team's offense whenever they needed it.
And you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray.
No one near Smith as he lets it go. Smith missing again.
Well, his shots aren't dropping, and they haven't been able to keep pace, but they trust him enough to keep going to him and see if he can find it.
Really seizing the momentum of this game, but doing it with a methodical approach.
Well, how good have they been on the inside tonight, just getting down into the painted area and just dominating, controlling that spot.
And the Knicks decide to take their first time out here.
You talk about players that have transformed their bodies in the NBA. How about Gordon Hayward? Has added muscle every year while maintaining that speed and agility. Carry all my dirt. Bury all of my sins, staring out of the beans. Gone with the wind, gone with the pretty long hairs with the fair skin. She repeated like a parody, and apparently she gon' keep up and never win. What low was that when I was sleeping on the couch and in the room? Probably with another tip. I'm on another tip. I'm skin so tense, strength on strength, 1 on 10 against me.
happen.
Yeah, for life, baby, I'm dressed for the baby girl, I'm your soldier. A tripping like this, black and forth, wonder who.
Now we'd like to take this moment to show you the teams that a year ago made a trademark of scoring points off turnovers. Fifth on the list, the Celtics.
And they turned all those mistakes into points at the other end. That aggressive style really yielding big dividends.
On defense, Boston, 15-point game. Count that one.
That's an easy shot provided by Dennis Smith Jr.
Now, here's Walker. He's guarded closely. It's good for the seventh time this game. He's shot seven. He has made seven. For three, Smith. Rebound by Williams. Williams has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight from the baseline. And there's Brown. That's good on the assist by Walker. 6 points for Jaylen Brown. Knicks trail by 17. And the official signaled the backcourt violation. Not very careful there. And the Celtics making a change here. Smart's checked in.
Smart.
Walker against Smith. Shot's good by Walker.
Walker.
Walker's got 17 now.
Yeah, these defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially inside.
Smith, the pass to Barrett. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time.
Assist from
5 points in the game.
And you like the toughness there. Barrett being more comfortable having to deal with an aggressive defense.
And it's good for two.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
Smith against Walker. Here's Knox. No good from outside. Last game for Boston, they picked up the W against the Magic in Orlando. Smart. It's good.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
And it's Smith with the ball. He brings it up for the Knicks. There's the triple. Barrett, no good. Boston leading by 21. Tatum drives in. He gets it in there.
Jason.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Well, if there were 4 or 5 boxes to check in terms of the game plan tonight, they might have checked 6. I mean, they're doing everything out there.
And Randall throws it down.
Randall with a great effort there. Up and athletic and at the rim.
Here's Walker. 9 for 9. Looking deadly accurate. Like, guys, he cannot miss.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
They get a hand on it. And it's Jason Tatum with the foul.
Jason.
That is his first foul of the game. Jimmy Ogilvy's checked in for the Celtics. The Knicks also changing it up. Portis, he's checked in for Mitchell Robinson. Gibson comes in for Randall. And it's Reggie Bullock in for Kevin Knox. Now, here is Smith. He's got 6, and it's Jason Tatum with the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game.
And that's his second foul already, and that's going to force him to tone down his aggression defensively.
Boston making some changes. Daniel Tice is checked in for Williams. Williams comes in for Tatum. And Langford subbed in for Walker. The Knicks also changing it up. Morris comes in for Barrett. And it's Trier in for Smith. Now, here is Morris. Coming in off a 21-point game, his last outing. 5 to shoot. Shot's good by Gibson.
Working on the inside, Taj Gibson goes to it. Tremendous at imposing his will down there.
Here's Smart. Morris with the rebound. Knicks trail by 21. To the wing right side. There's Trier with the 3. And no good that time. The New York Knicks, they come in off the loss to the Wizards.
And a trying summer for the New York Knicks fans. After trading away Porzingis, they were hoping to get a big-name player in free agency, Greg, and they didn't.
You know, shocking, they refused to offer the max to Kevin Durant. I mean, there were concerns with the Achilles, but instead he ends up in Brooklyn. Combine that with fans' disappointment at missing out on Zion Williamson, and the saga continues.
Now, here's Langford. Following the miss by Marcus Morris, Langford, the shot, no good. Great D that time from Gibson. Williams with the block. Tice passes to Ogilvy. High post try, no good that time. Now the Knicks take it the other way. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Bullock with it. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Near the three-point line, it's Morris. Again, the miss by Morris.
Now that's just enough defensive pressure on him to throw off that shot. I bet he gets a good look at it next time and hits it.
Excellent all-around performance so far, hence the big lead.
Well, if I was baking up a lead, I'd add two ingredients. One would be playing smart. The other one, playing selfless. They've done that tonight. Serve it up.
Here's Bullock, following the basket by Romeo Langford. Three-pointer. Morris, no good.
And he just hasn't been able to make anything this quarter.
Second shot opportunity. No good that time. Now the Knicks take it the other way.
A team's rebounding is a great measure of its energy, and theirs has been terrific here in the first quarter.
And now here comes Williams leading the break, and it's Williams finishing it off.
And I think that play sort of sums up what we've seen tonight. Just simply being outplayed both sides of the ball. Smart basketball defensively, turning into easy points.
Now here is Morris.
That's nice vision there. You see that pass, you make the feed before the defense has a chance to react, and that opens up a much better opportunity to score.
Nice. And there are the Celtics with another basket.
That's the kind of passing you want there. Work the ball around, keep it moving, try to get an assist on every bucket.
Morris outside. Nailed from three-point land.
And a guy with more of a mid-range game, Morris can still jack it up from deep if you give him enough space and time.
Nice shot by Smart.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Well, I know they don't have mobile devices out there for texting, so they might as well talk to one another, Greg.
And it's Gibson finishing it off.
Got to keep Taj out of the post. How many of those have we seen?
Here's Smart, and there are the Celtics with another basket.
And a lot of teams avoid the mid-range jumper, but they seem to be using it well.
2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. All sorts of time. Rebound Boston. Williams has got 4 rebounds in this game. And Langford with the basket on the assist by Williams. 6 points for Romeo Langford. Right side, Portis. Over Tice. And no luck with that time on the buzzer beater. And so it's the Boston Celtics in complete command. Their lead at 28 points going into the break. From the field, they have been outstanding, amazing shooting. That's what has them headed to a blowout. And we'll be back with you shortly. Gordon Hayward reunited with his college coach, Brad Stevens. He said they go way back.
Our relationship started when I was in high school. He came to my morning workouts and really recruited me at Butler and was kind of the first guy that I think believed in me that I could make it to the next level.
And I'm sure, Greg, that relationship played a big role in Hayward deciding to join the Boston Celtics.
And not just a connection, but a respect. Hayward now a veteran in this league, while Stevens has moved into the conversation to one of the better young coaches in our league.
Taj Gibson.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And guys, we've seen the Celtics really take control here.
Stingy on the defensive end in that first quarter. They were just getting up into people.
Just a great job, really, of making the game ugly, trying to muck it up a little bit out there.
We've got Williams. Langford out there with Marcus Smart. Then it's Enes Kanter. And it's Ojeleye in at the three. That's the Boston Five. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, last season we thought the Knicks' cornerstone player was Kristaps Porzingis. But the player and the team fell out of love with each other, and the Knicks traded him to Dallas. The draft picks and cap space freed them up for a wild summer, led by the drafting of rookie R.J. Barrett in the draft. Now New York has one of the more drastically revamped rosters in the league. Kevin, there's a lot to be excited about going forward in the Big Apple.
Big moves indeed, David. Thank you.
And I just watched Romeo Langford. And guys, he looks the part in every way. Big, smooth, great change of direction, and he can flat out score.
Here's Trier. 14 points from him the last game against Washington.
Yeah, and they've shown effort and aggression in the paint, really, right from the tip. Their rebounding edge right now, massive.
Nice shot by Smart. And talking about Langford's ability to put up points, he has that popular step-back jumper, Greg, that's so difficult to defend.
Yeah, and you immediately think of James Harden, but a lot of guys use that step-back. The one thing Langford does well, he gets to the rim where he can use all that length.
Now that's the kind of passing right there that makes a difference, not just in that possession, but maybe on your play for the entire game.
And if that's the best look you can get on a possession, what a waste of a trip down the floor.
Yeah, see the coach? He's got that frown on his face. I think we know why. Not a high percentage look.
Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going. What a performance on the offensive end. He's making the defenders pay right now for all of the mistakes they're making.
Pass to Portis. Here's Trier. He's covered by Kanter. Williams with the block. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw coming up.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
First foul, team's first.
The Celtics shooting their first free throw of the game here.
And as a team, excellent a season ago. About 80% when they got to the line.
And some changes here for the Celtics. Gordon Hayward's checked in for Williams. Jaylen Brown comes in for Langford. And it's Kemba Walker in for Marcus Smart. So New York going with almost an entire new group here. Julius Randle's checked in for Portis. Kevin Knox comes in for Taj Gibson. Barrett's checked in for Marcus Morris. And Smith's subbed in for Alonzo Trier. Brent, so many guys are now shooting from well beyond the arc. Who do you think has the deepest range in the league?
I think Steph Curry has the most consistent, deepest range.
Lillard is in that category.
Lillard is in there, and of course, last year's playoff win will never go away in terms of what a great memory that was. Trae Young is now entering that category, Kevin.
Yeah.
I mean, we saw that at the end of last year. His fearlessness in pulling up from just about anywhere has been pretty remarkable. And to that, I will add one Brooke Lopez, who has found his way well beyond the three-point line.
He's a whole nother conversation.
We'll talk about him later.
We'll do that. Here are the Celtics with the ball. They're on a 16-4 run. Here's Walker, and it's Boston with another.
That is how he rolls. A prolific scorer. Walker's been calling his own number tonight.
Smith for three. That shot off the mark, and it's Boston the other way. Following this one, they get to host the Cavaliers. And that game is the second of two straight at home.
Walker.
Shot's good by Walker.
And he has his fingerprints all over this first half. He is just shooting it so efficiently.
Now, here is Smith. 6 points for him. Here's Knox. And the call will be against Julius Randle.
Julius.
That is his first foul of the game.
First personal.
Jason Tatum, he's checked in for Ogilvy. Robinson's checked in for the Knicks. Celtics. And now, the first timeout called here for Boston.
Well, you knew it was going to take some time for Kevin Knox, but Greg, at the end of last season, he began to show flashes of what he could do.
You could almost see the game starting to slow down for him about halfway through the season. Consistency is something all rookies struggle with, but it hit Knox especially hard. Fortunately, that is something that passes with time.
The soul, just when the world's saying they got no hope, here comes the love. We got audio. We flying high, superhero. That's on my chest with my Marilyn Monroe. Feel like a star.
And here we can check out the story on Julius Randle. He's coming off an excellent season, 19th in scoring. And he was among the top 20 rebounders in the league. Never shy about throwing his weight around in the paint.
Yeah, and like you said, one of the better scorers in the NBA last season, a tireless worker on the offensive end. He could be even better this season.
You got a shadow Walker. His mid-range game is on point.
Now, here's Barrett. He's covered by Brown. In the corner, Knox with it. Here's Smith. And the shot goes in.
Dennis.
Smith's got 8 points.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
And again, it's Boston converting.
Boy, has he put his foot on the pedal here this quarter. He's doing a terrific job in terms of leading their offense.
Now, here is Robinson. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. They get it back. Randall, the stupendous finish in traffic.
If somebody not alert to block out the wide frame of Julius Randle, who gets in there after the loose ball.
Took him no time at all on that one. 32 points for Walker.
And they're leaning on the mid-range right now. That's 6 of their last 10 from that area.
For 3, Smith. Smith missing again.
He's been off the mark, and that hasn't helped them chip away at the lead. It's been a theme here this quarter.
He's going to be shaking his head on that one. Knows he missed an easy one.
Yeah, you can't make them all, and you for sure you'll want him taking that kind of shot. Kevin Knox was a bit of a mixed bag in his rookie season, and that's to be expected on a team that didn't have a tremendous amount of consistent talent on the floor. He struggled with his scoring and showed some flashes shooting the ball. It'll be interesting in year two where it is that Kevin Knox has made some improvements in the offseason.
First free throw is good. And with Knox, Brent, the athleticism is clearly there.
Oh, he can get up and down with the best of them and can rise up and do some exciting things. But for Kevin Knox, it's about consistency. Can he get to some spots on the floor where every night he's capable of making plays, whether that's for him or doing something off the bounce? That's the next step for Kevin Knox.
Especially in the playoffs, Brent, so much can change when a player gets into foul trouble. See the league ever modifying that foul out rule?
I know that they do that in the summer league where you can stay on the court for 10 fouls as elimination, yeah. But it's a technical every time. I don't see the league doing that. I think it's good for the game so that star players or meaningful players, ones that play specifically on defense, they have to have responsibility for what it is that they're doing on the floor. And if they're overly aggressive, you should be penalized for playing that.
And how about that show of confidence from Tatum? He really excels at playing above the rim and taking that one home.
Here's Knox. He has 5. And the pass to Barrett. And Tatum over to help. Back to Knox. Wants to get it to Robinson and does.
Randle kicks to Barrett. Smith the pass to Barrett. Here's Randle. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
That's his first personal.
Randle really improved in his shooting range from 10 to 16 feet last year, and that just makes him so much more a complete offensive threat in any system he plays in.
And the first one drops. And he's flourishing as a scorer. But Brent, how does Julius Randle take that next step?
Well, I think, Kevin, if he keeps improving on his consistency, shooting from that 10-foot to 16-foot range where guys are daring him to shoot and not wanting to deal with him driving into them. You know, last year, he went up 6 percentage points from 35% to 41% in that 10 to 16-foot range. You keep seeing that kind of improvement, the growth in his game is going to come.
It's Brown with the drive. Yep, that one goes in there. Brown's got 10 points.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for New York. Atlanta will be traveling to face them after this game. That'll be the first of two straight at home. Here's Randle, and stolen by Tatum. And pushing it up, here's Boston. Walker's running, got that one up quick. Walker's got 34 points.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Coaching staff probably most proud of the effort of this team on both ends of the floor here tonight.
Now, here is Smith. He's got 8. They get it back. And the shot is good. Robinson's got his first basket.
And a better box out saves them 2 points there.
It didn't seem like anybody was really aware there to go and collect that rebound in the possession.
Now, here is Smith. After Gordon Hayward's miss, Barrett offline with his 3.
And just not able to find the target from 3-point range here in the second quarter, although he did knock down one in the first.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
And for the Knicks, they're shooting 33% for the night. That's a big thorn in their side right now. Over to the left wing. Off the mark there with the 3-point shot.
Yeah, we're chipping some orange paint off the rim here, guys. He must be more patient on offense and trying to find ways to penetrate inside and get closer to the rim.
And, yeah, he's not messing around. He wants no part of a comeback in this one.
Well, he's grabbed a tee and a blanket because he's putting this one to bed. Hate to say it, but if they're still trailing at the final buzzer, a lot of this is going to be felt by him. His shooting tonight has just been atrocious.
Yeah, a big part of this run here has been their ability to score from mid-range.
Here's Smith. Jason Tatum picking up that last basket.
And you see the passing instincts Barrett has. Great at recognition out on the floor.
Tatum's shot is off. Knicks shooting a cool 28% in the second quarter. Smith on the wing, guarded by Walker. That one falls. 10 points for Julius Randle.
Disappointing as a player to have such a great game and still be trailing. Not over yet, though.
Shot's good by Walker
with the shot.
And he has just been in a flow offensively. Terrific game. He has been the X factor.
Smith on the wing from downtown. Knicks with a new 14. And Randle throws it down.
And, you know, it's one thing to get the offensive rebound, but then how about the loud bucket he's able to convert?
He was in perfect position under the hoop, Greg. You're right. Once he gets his hands on the miss. Now, here's Bullock. Jason Tatum missing his last shot. And Barrett slams it in.
And you see the edge Barrett plays with, attacking the rim with bad intention.
That one misses. Randle with some nice D. And he's going up for the alley-oop, and Robinson throws it down hard.
And the pass there floated it up to the precise spot it needed to be.
And no messing around on the finish. He powers it through. Brown, good.
And sure, the D was all over Brown, but in the end, he's just too skilled for them in the paint.
Here's Barrett. And a miss there on the triple. Boston's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. And yes, it's good. 14 points for Jaylen Brown. A minute 20 left in the second quarter. Smith outside. In the corner, Barrett with it. Jacks up a three. Rebound by Williams. Williams has got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Here's Tatum. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Brown's got 3 assists now in this one.
Not just the accuracy in the quarter, it's his movement and the energy that's getting him on this nice roll.
Bullock passes to Smith. There's 48 seconds left in the first half of the game. Feeds it to Robinson. Up and in for the basket, number 4. That makes him 4 for 5 now.
Yeah, this story in the second quarter, much different than the one in the first. We're finally seeing some aggression.
Now Barrett, 9 points in the game so far. Here's Bullock. And there are the Knicks with another bucket.
Timeout.
The mid-range jumper is a high percentage shot for him. And when he's got that much room, forget about it.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
And as things present themselves throughout a game, teams have to adapt on the fly.
And timeouts are a wonderful opportunity to just settle in and recollect the thoughts of your entire team. Not just the guys playing, but the entire team, Greg.
An entire new group here. Daniel Tice is checked in for Tatum. Shemi Ojeleye comes in for Gordon Hayward. Langford's checked in for Jaylen Brown. And Marcus Smart is subbed in for Kemba Walker. Nice shot by Smart.
For a guy who's still working on his range, love to see Smart attacking on the interior.
Smart's got nearly everything to drop for him, shooting 5 of 6 from the field. And he gets the bucket.
Oh, that's a needle in the haystack shot right there. You're not going to hit that one all that often.
It's stolen by Morris. Pass to Trier with 2 seconds left. Offensive rebound. Kemba Walker firing on all cylinders for the Boston Celtics. He's approaching 40 points for him in the game. He's scoring in just about every way possible. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks, Kevin. Here with head coach Brad Stevens. Coach, what did you think was the main edge you had?
Well, I thought defensively we were a lot better, and then that led to some offense. But obviously, we're playing a bunch of skilled guys, and we're able to spread the floor, and that's helpful.
You have to make them work at both ends. Thanks, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you, and stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter started.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Boy, what a crowd joining us here for our halftime report. I'm Ernie Johnson alongside Kenny the Jet Smith and the Diesel Shaquille O'Neal. We saw Kemba Walker lighting it up in the first half. He had 38 points, 5 assists, and 1 rebound. His last game out, he was just not himself. But tonight, he has rounded right back into form with a very solid first half. Kenny, what's your take on Boston so far?
Terrific performance so far by Kemba Walker. Tremendous team leader who's become a star in this league. He could be your catalyst offensively, and he makes big shots.
Shaq, what'd you think about New York?
Well, you live by the three and you die by the three. And today, they're dying. And as cold as they've been behind the arc, they keep firing for me. What are you doing? I know they got a lot of ground to make up, but they can't continue with this game plan. Not working.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. We'll see you again after the final
horn. Oh, buzzer.
Walking in the sunshine.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. What a game we're seeing from Kemba Walker.
Well, we'll find out if they were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease in that first half.
Yeah, just way too easy out there, and I'm sure Coach is going to make that a priority at halftime.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. The Knicks shooting a lackluster 38% for the game, struggling so far. Tipping off the second half, here's David Fizdale's five. It's Randall and Robinson at the four and the five. Barrett and Knox are the wingmen. And it's Smith in at the point. From the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Kevin, before he became a head coach in Memphis and New York, David Fizdale spent eight seasons as an assistant under Eric Spoelstra in Miami. Now, Spo said he's a brilliant basketball mind that has exceptional gold standard level communication skills. One of the most talented coaches I've been around. So, Kevin, Fizdale is highly respected.
David, he sure is. Great reputation. Now getting his shot. Thank you so much. And Randall throws it down.
And the second chance becomes a dunk. We could feel over here.
Yeah, G.A., such a good, aggressive play in the paint. Robinson with the block.
You talk about things at halftime, and then you come out and you go 0 for 3. I'm sure that wasn't up on the board.
Oh, and there's the alley-oop and the dunk by Robinson.
Oh, such a beautiful pass to set that one up.
Yeah, the pass might have been pretty, but the finish was angry. Brown, good.
Yes, finally one drops after the 0 of 3 start.
And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for New York.
I think Mitchell Robinson is one of those guys. We saw it last year. He might get 4 or 5 blocks a game. So many players tempted to shoot outside shots because Mitchell would play off of them, and then quickly he would get to them and deflect the shot. So incredible quick twitch fibers and quick to the ball to make an impact defensively.
Clearly a foul.
That's his first personal foul.
And with Robinson, if he played a full 40 minutes every game, Brent, his block numbers would be outstanding.
Look at you, Kevin, digging into the per 36 minutes statistics.
Yeah.
I like it. He's a great rim protector. He has great activity down there. And if he can stay with the game plan, I think Coach Fizdale is going to find ways to give him more minutes in this season.
The first one falls.
And the vertical that Brown has is pretty impressive, as relentless a finisher as you'll find in our league.
And Brown drops them both. And for Jaylen Brown, part of the challenge last season, especially with the return of Gordon Hayward, was meeting the high expectations, Greg, in a reduced role.
Competition for minutes, and then early on, he struggled. We all see the potential, but it's really about seizing the moment every time you're on the court.
Here's Walker, and good, and it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Walker's got 40 points. The Knicks have gotten 6 of their 7 shots to go down in this quarter. What a fantastic start to the half. And count it, the shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line.
Brown. And what a basket by Barrett, looking unafraid to take on these difficult challenges down low.
And for a lot of these kids, Greg, it's interesting how quickly teams expect them to get up to speed. Case in point, R.J. Barrett.
Yeah, I mean, he had only the 1 year of college, already being asked to produce. Fortunately, he's very mature for his age and generally plays up to the level of competition.
Mind the lane. One shot.
And that one falls for Barrett. And Greg, talking to scouts about R.J. Barrett, they love the athleticism. But what makes him especially good is the work ethic and the confidence.
Yeah, some elite prospects will take plays off. This guy never does. He's not one that sits around and reads his press clippings. He's a warrior, a leader, and he's proven to be a winner.
Here's Smith after Gordon Hayward's bucket.
Knox getting up there and showing the power he possesses.
It's taken away by Smith. Here's Barrett. Lays it up off the glass. Barrett's got 14 points now in the second half.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
Tatum's shot is off. The Knicks shooting in this game, 45%. To the paint. And Barrett slams it in.
It's an incredible night for Barrett. He scores in a multitude of ways, and he brings the effort on every possession.
Inside, here's Cantor. The shot's good. Brown making the play.
Two teammates connecting right there. Slick feed.
And Cantor over to help. In the corner, Knox with it. The three. Here's Robinson. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time. Robinson's got 4 points in the quarter. Here's Cantor, and it's Boston with another.
Cantor. The mechanics didn't look too bad there. Cantor with the quick release and excellent follow-through.
Here's Randall, and Randall throws it down.
And not the prototype power forward, but he has tremendous athletic ability.
Brown drives in. He sinks the 11-footer. Brown's got 20 points. New York's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Bounce pass, Smith. Tatum against Randall. In it goes for the 8th time in 10 tries.
And they found the touch from the field here in the second half. It was a struggle in that first.
Tatum. And again, it's Boston converted.
And really at his best from mid-range, Tatum can create space and shoot up over his defenders.
Smith, the pass to Robinson. Barrett with the ball. The shot from the low post is good. 27 points for him.
This is not a player who likes to be trailing in any game. That lights a fire.
Here's Cantor. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and 2 shots coming up.
And truth is, Cantor is a fairly high percentage shooter inside. Sometimes better in this case to send him to the line.
The Celtics have made 3 free throws so far. Haven't missed any.
Shooting 2.
That's good from Cantor.
Such a big guy, Cantor, but also incredibly lean. At the NBA Combine, for instance, he tested out at 6% body fat. An extraordinarily low number for a man of his size.
Williams, he's checked in for the Celtics. Smart comes in for Jaylen Brown. Taj Gibson's checked in for the Knicks. So he picks up just 1 from the line that time. Brent, we have seen some international showcase games the last few years. Do you like that trend?
Oh, absolutely. I like the fact that our league, we know how global it is with how many players from different countries are represented throughout the rosters around the league. But for our game to travel around to London and to Mexico City and have an opportunity for those fans to see what NBA basketball is like, I think it's an absolute win for the
NBA. I'd like
to
see more.
Well, more time for those teams. The timing of some of those trips for some teams are a little bit tough in terms of the travel, but their appearances there mean so much more to grow the game globally.
And there's the bucket from Tatum.
And how about the decision-making by Tatum there? I mean, fantastic at just having a feel for what the defense is going to do and then creating the space there for the jumper.
Now, here is Smith. He's got 10. Knox, stolen by Walker. To the middle. And it's blocked.
This has to energize Barrett. He needs to keep bringing this type of intensity to the defensive end.
A nice shot by Tatum.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
He's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
Now here's Gibson. Tips it up.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
And slam dunk by Tatum.
How about the speed with which Tatum gets down the court? Awesome at reading the defense and then exploiting the opportunity in the open floor.
New York's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Out left to the wing. Here's Knox. Traps in the tray.
Kevin Knox.
Knox has got 5 points in the quarter.
They're kind of like playing in the rec league. Little to no defense on that possession. And the easiest three-pointer you can imagine.
And now the Knicks on the break. Here's Smith. And then Smith with the dunk.
That's a pretty gritty play there by Dennis Smith Jr.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
And a breakout season for Julius Randle in 2018-19. Averaged close to 20-10. Delivering on the talent that saw him taken 7th overall back in 2014.
Some changes. Daniel Tice is checked in for Cantor. Shemi Ojeleye comes in for Jason Tatum. And Langford subbed in for Walker. So New York going with almost an entire new group. Portis, he's checked in for Randall. Marcus Morris comes in for Kevin Knox. Alonzo Trier is checked in for Barrett. And Ellington is subbed in for Smith. New York's gone 2-3 when they ventured outside the arc in the third quarter. New York moving it around. That one goes in. Trier's got 6.
Now, lead passes like that are so hard to defend. He never had to break his stride. So full speed, 2 points.
New York shooting well, 50% from the floor. Morris outside, lets it go from deep. And Boston with the rebound. Williams has got 6 rebounds here tonight. Ojeleye passes to Tice. The dish now to Langford. And he dunks it down.
Nice there. Getting the reverse. Love that. And the fans got a little bit of a show there.
Guys, that one definitely had a little something extra on it. Up top, Ellington. Guarded by Smart. Morris kicks to Portis. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Portis has got his first 2 points.
And say what you will about the value of the three-pointer, but those close-in looks are always plan A. Every trip down, get to the paint, get deep, score.
A lethal attacker. Langford enjoys finding those avenues to the bucket and then just torching the defense.
He's getting his first free throw attempt of the game here.
At the line with one shot.
One of those guards who just oozes with potential. Langford has the size and skill set that every team is looking for.
Now here's Ellington. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Here's Trier. In the corner, Gibson with it. Just 5 to shoot. Trier in the corner for 3. Ojeleye grabs the rebound. Ojeleye's got 4 rebounds now tonight. From deep 3-point range, Knicks with the rebound.
And if you have to admire his confidence on that, but there's no way that's going to fall.
Coaches will tell you that's a bad shot, but when your teammates tell you that, you probably got to think about it.
Now, here is Morris. Here's Gibson. Yes, once again, it remains perfect. Six attempts and six hits.
Gibson using his body on the boards. He's great at using his timing to leap up and collect a second chance.
Sinks the three-pointer.
Yeah, not where he earns his money, that three-point shot. But he's a good shooter from that range if he's got space.
And here is Morris after Marcus Smart got his shot to go from deep. Pass to Ogilvy. Whistle blows, bucket is good, and he'll have a chance at the line to make it a three-point play.
Knicks foul call.
Yeah, outstanding job there of taking the harm and still able to finish.
And this is his second trip to the line tonight.
And you know, you'll take what he can give you from the free throw line. Looking at his numbers, just really not one of his strengths. Shooting in the low 60s last season.
Robert Williams, he's checked in for Williams. And New York with a change here, too. Reggie Bullock, he's checked in for Taj Gibson.
And they're doing a better job of working themselves to the line here in the second half.
New York's gone a less than productive 2 of 6 from three-point land in the second half. Here's Trier. He has 6. Ellington, the pass to Bullock. To the inside, Portis. That shot missing. Williams with the defensive effort. And so it's Smart. He'll bring up the ball for Boston. Bangs home the trifecta. Smart's got 6 in the quarter.
And, of course, this is Smart's biggest hurdle. Sometimes he looks great shooting the 3. Sometimes, though, it's just the opposite.
To stop the run. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
Yeah, that play never gets old, Kevin. The pick and roll will still be an offensive staple 100 years from now. Trust me.
And the sharpshooter, Reggie Bullock. Took some time for him, Greg, here in the NBA. But, you know, he's going to shoot it.
Bullock has always been a consistent threat from outside. And that is why this team loves him. It doesn't offer too much else, but he can open up some room inside with that ability to hit from deep.
One shot.
Boston's gotten going here in the second half from outside, nailing 3 of 4 from the arc. Puts it up from 15. Bullock with the rebound.
Well, if you believe in the numbers, that mid-range shot is not a high-value shot, even with little or no defense on you.
And I like the different looks that Morris can give you, inside, outside, and in transition.
Here's Tice. The Knicks pull it in.
Pretty lax defense there. He's going to see fewer and fewer chances if he can't bury those kind of jumpers.
Boston's gone to three-point range 7 times tonight, knocked down 5 of them. And that one drops. Tice has got 6.
And you see Langford's ability as a facilitator. Great court awareness.
Pass to Bullock from outside the arc. Rebound by the Celtics. Williams has got 11 rebounds in the game. Langford has the open look. Gets a very good look and converts. Langford's got 21.
And that set them apart today, guys. Their success with the mid-range.
Inside, a great 1-2 punch. Beautiful pass and nasty jam.
It really does make the game easy for your teammates when you can lead them to the rim that well with a pass.
The Knicks shooting straight 49% from the field. Back to Trier. And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
Of all the action happening there, Kevin, it's the assist that jumps out to me there. That's just a great look and a great setup for the bucket.
On the wing, Ellington. Back to Bullock. There's the pass to Ellington. And the wide open shot from Morris. And the Knicks getting another bucket right there.
And dangerous in that catch and shoot game. In fact, anytime Morris can square up, he's a lot more consistent.
And so it's the Boston Celtics going to the break, holding an enormous 36-point lead. They have been excellent at both ends of the floor, the scoreboard showing what a complete performance this has been. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. And meanwhile, Coach Brad Stevens talking to his team.
Now, as we add stops and add scores, don't let the little things get us off kilter, okay? Play with poise. Let's go.
Well, clearly, Greg trying to keep his team on the same page.
Yeah, I mean, really challenging his guys right now, encouraging them to just stay focused on the task at hand.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Langford out there with Edwards. Then there's Daniel Tice. Then it's Williams. And it's Ogilvy in at the three spot. That's the Boston Five. Here's Portis following the basket by Romeo Langford. Peyton in the corner. Fires the three. Good on the three-point shot.
Man, if Peyton wants to stay in this league for a long time, that shot has to be more and more consistent. That's a good sign.
A baseline J. Again, the Celtics good for two. So it's the Knicks now. Here's a garbage time question, Brent. Why do some teams leave their star players in the game even though the game has either been won or lost?
Forgetful coaches? No. Well, I don't know if...
If you're leading by 35 points late in the game.
And the star player is still in the game. Yeah. Somebody's made a mistake with regards to the rotations. I mean, quite frankly, there's really no reason for guys to be out there at that time.
Yeah.
Early on in the season, it might be that the coach wants to start and play with certain guys. But as the season goes on, you just don't see that.
So they foul intentionally.
Yeah, not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a brain cramp.
Down low, here's Portis, and Portis throws it down.
Bobby.
Yeah, undersized guys with athleticism do these kind of things, playing above the rim. Love to see him get up like that.
Poirier, no good.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D out of position, you could see the frustration on his face.
Morris, no good.
That's the only kind of defense that's going to cut the mustard here tonight. You got to stay on top of a guy like that who can play at such a high level offensively.
Man, he sure can get off the floor.
He's one of the best in the business, absolutely. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Peyton surveying the floor. Passes it to Portis. Releases from 15. Bank shot, no good.
Probably not the shot that was drawn up for that possession, but you can't pass it up, and you can't knock it down.
And that one is good. Ogilvy's got 9 points now in just the second half.
And this is why coaches talk about playing with pace. The scoreboard tells it all.
Kind of get a team defensively on their heels, and if you can keep pushing and keep attacking, they'd never find some kind of defensive balance to help slow you down.
And 5 straight triple-doubles last season for Elfrid Payton, showing his all-around impact.
Amazing with his size and athleticism at the point guard position that he has that kind of versatility. That's some lofty company. I mean, 5 straight triple-doubles, what an amazing run by EP.
First one falls for. Brent, we have seen some players refuse to speak to the media. For whatever reason, where should that line be drawn?
Well, there is a role and a responsibility, I think, of every player in the league, Kevin, given that it's an entertainment industry and that people have jobs around this league to tell stories, to have access to those players. Now, every player doesn't want to talk or get into certain things, but their availability should be made and people should have access to them. Look, I don't want to take out the trash every Tuesday, but I understand I got to do it at home. And so players have a responsibility to their franchise to be a voice at times.
I always thought you were terrific with the media.
Well, I appreciate that, Kevin. Maybe that's how I got this job.
Here's Dotson, and he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Dotson's got his first points of the game.
Well, you risk getting torched when somebody's open. Peyton's skilled enough to find the open man.
Chalk up two there.
And the combination of his quickness and soft touch around the rim really allows him to pull off shots like that. A lot of players don't have the reverse in their arsenal.
Langford, and Langford with the stuff.
Another one for Langford. We talk about his high ceiling, primarily at the offensive end.
A look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. To the paint, here's Dotson. The lead pass was put in just the right spot.
Now catching the lead pass at full speed, terrific anticipation. And the delivery, Kevin, on time, on target.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
It was a season of rebuilding, and Damian Dotson was certainly a bright spot for the Knicks, a guy that just loves to let it fly, and he found his way into some minutes after some roster turnover and made the best of his chances for Coach Fizdale.
Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. And for Dotson, Brent, it's not always easy for second-round picks to find the chance to increase their role.
Yeah, you wonder, Kevin, if being a second-round pick isn't the thing we should be talking about. It's about Dotson spending 4 years in college and coming in with a more mature perspective so that when the opportunity arose for him to take advantage, he would do so. Looks like he's found a spot in the league.
Here's Edwards, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Edwards got 4 points now in the quarter.
And running with a full head of steam, but completely under control.
Yeah, you think he's comfortable at that speed? He's done it so many times before. Just an absolute blur in transition, and that helps get the rhythm going.
And it's Peyton, that time on the assist by Morris. Morris has got his fourth assist in this one. Here's Langford. Sinks that one from the post. Langford's got 31 points.
Not lacking any confidence down there. Just give Langford the ball and let him do his thing.
Here's Dotson. Peyton outside. Shot clock at 6. Dotson in the corner. Fires the 3. And again, New York with the triple.
And I tell you what, they're doing their best to cut down the lead with some smart offense here in the second half. Shot selection much improved since the break.
Count that bucket.
And I'll bet his percentage is pretty high from that range.
New York's gotten off to a great start from three-point range in the final quarter. They're a perfect 3 of 3. Poked away. Here's Edwards. And he banks in the layup.
I mean, the stroke looks good. He's moving well out there. What a sensational start to this game. Perfect from the field.
Knicks have gone 7 of 11 from the floor in the final quarter so far. And some solid looks for them. Peyton kicks to Bullock. On the wing, Morris. Outside, Portis. No good on the 3. Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. Of course, Dirk Nowitzki spent his whole career with the Dallas Mavericks. We don't see that much anymore, do we, from the beginning to the end with one team?
No, but I think we're going to still occasionally have anomalies like we did with Reggie being in Indiana. Yes. For the years of his playing career. Nate McMillan was in Seattle for his playing career, now coach of the Indiana Pacers. So there will be times where we'll have that once or twice. It's not going to happen very much, Kevin.
Not in today's game,
and not with what's at stake. They got no hope. Here comes the love.
We got audio. We flying high, superhero. It's on my chest with my Marilyn Monroe. Feel like a star. We got audio.
Celtics making a switch here. Williams has checked in. And the Knicks making a change here as well. Gibson's checked in. Here's Edwards. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim.
A fine passer for that position. Langford's selflessness is why his teammates enjoy playing with him.
Now here's Payton. Pass to Bullock. And here is Payton, rebounded by the Celtics. Langford's got four rebounds now tonight. And Langford with the stop.
And how about the hops Langford has? Terrific at just rising up and being free and then throwing it down.
And so Payton will bring it up for New York to end the run. Poirier grabs the miss. Boston's gone to three-point range seven times tonight, knocked down five of them. Langford, he can't get that one to fall. Now the Knicks take it the other way. Pass to Bullock. Player salary is obviously a large investment, Brent. What are some other investments that owners can make to help their team get better, either on the floor or off?
Massive one, Kevin, obviously, is in terms of your players' wellness and what it is that you're doing with your physical therapy staff, your strength and conditioning staff, because you want these guys available at the best and maximum potential physically that they can give you. A lot of teams, quite frankly, in the past couple of seasons, Kevin, looking into other ways, holistic therapies, mental approach that they can have mental wellness for their players as part of their programming. So teams that think you build some beautiful practice facility and just let the guys go bounce the ball around and shoot are absolutely missing. Yeah, they're missing the boat on what it is that their players require, need, and need to be complete as people.
Now here's Payton. Pass to Dotson. Clock at four. 13 feet away. Rebounded by the Celtics. Poirier's got his fourth rebound in this one. Over Gibson. Poirier, no good.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Here's Bullock. Unable to get that one. Williams with the defensive effort. And there's the foul. Goes on Taj Gibson. Taj gets his third foul of the game.
Yeah, clearly a foul of frustration right there.
For the Knicks, Portis comes in for Morris, and it's Trier in for Reggie Bullock. Passes to Ogilvy. Fires it up. Score the basket. It's number six for him this game. Six for nine, 67% shooting.
Are we sure that's the same player, guys? He looks completely different. What confidence he's playing with, and look how engaged he is on both ends.
Guys, some great passing from him.
Yeah, everybody's touching it, and you're starting to see the assists pile up because the rhythm is on display offensively.
To leave a guy like that wide open from range, big mix-up.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Left side, Gibson. Outside, Portis. Six on the shot clock. Fires from deep. Drains the three-pointer. Dotson's got 10 points in the quarter.
Feels like the other four guys have disappeared at this point. He wants to be the one to get them back.
Edwards can't hit.
Well, he finds some space in that in-between gap there, Kevin. Too bad he can't release that one on target.
And he just elevates and powers in the one-hander.
Mm-hmm. Textbook. Williams, that's a two-pointer. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. Taj Gibson picks one up. Brent, when we talk about home court advantage, do you feel it's the same as it used to be? It has that same impact?
I do think it's still hugely important, Kevin. It's less important when there's a team that has been together for a long time and has proven that they can take their wares on the road and come home with a victory. But it absolutely gives you a level of comfort as a player to get into your routine, to be at a place that seems familiar. Something deep down psychologically helps every member of that team being at home.
So he gets them both. New York's gone 4-7 with the long ball here in the fourth quarter. Kicks it to Payton. And they double up Payton. Pass to Dotson. Pass to Portis. And he comes up with the deuce.
Two teammates connecting right there. Slick feed.
Yes, yes. Dane Dotson.
On the wing, here's Ogilvy. Goes up again, and it's good on the layup.
How frustrating for the defense. You get the stop, but then fail to block out.
Yeah, that pops your confident balloon out there, just completely deflating when plays like that happen.
And a wide-open look for Portis. That's in, coming off an assist from Payton.
For three.
Payton's got six assists now in the game. Here's Langford. Here's Poirier, and good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Celtics.
It was a standout performance across the board.
I mean, it was like watching a cat play with a mouse. They were able to do more or less whatever they wanted.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year. And one of the key components to this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for Kemba Walker.
Now, this was a showcase night of his skills offensively.
Brent, with advanced analytics becoming commonplace in the NBA, which stats do you personally hold most valuable?
Well, it's amazing to talk about effective field goal percentage. Mm-hmm. I laugh a lot
Which is everything shooting, free throws.
Yeah, well, I like to use true shooting percentage, Kevin, because that's where you adopt three-point shooting percentage, two-point shooting percentage, and your free throw percentage.
Everything.
But in talking to a lot of people around the league, general managers and coaches, I laugh inside to myself a little bit, like, oh, so now shooting's important? Like, what? Like now shooting's important the league?
Right.
As if, you know, the time that you go out to start playing basketball, you grab a ball, you go towards the goal, and your goal is to make the shot. And so we're talking so much more about how much shooting is valued. Effective field goal percentage is tremendous, with true shooting percentage being not far behind.
But they recover it. Here's Ogilvy. It's rebounded by Portis. Now the Knicks with it. The pass to Trier. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
That's the kind of passing you want there. Work the ball around, keep it moving, try to get an assist on every bucket.
Now a timeout called by Boston. They lead by 47. We've got 28 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What's your take, guys?
And a surprising timeout here with the game in the bag.
Sometimes you want to have these teachable moments on the floor and not in the next day's film session, so coach electing to do that here.
Our Jordan player of the game, Kemba Walker.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
This is as good a game as we've seen him play. And this crowd can't get enough of it. When he explodes like this, it becomes a special atmosphere in here. It's a 4-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Again, the miss by the Celtics. To the inside. And it's Payton. That time on the assist by Ellington.
Well, at this point, they're just trying to get back in sync. You want to play a good brand of basketball.
Consistency definitely is a key to some of the playoff performing teams. And tonight, they just did not find it in this contest.
And so they choose to intentionally foul.
Yeah, not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a brain cramp.
Now a timeout called by Boston. They're up by 47. There's 10 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Guys, what do you think?
And a surprising timeout here with the game in the bag.
Sometimes you want to have these teachable moments on the floor and not in the next day's film session, so coach electing to do that here.
An intentional foul right there.
Shemi Ozeley. That's his second personal foul. Shooting for New York, Bobby Portis. At the line for two.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he makes the first. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. So it's Boston now. Now here's Edwards from deep. Off target.
Well, that height and the length from the point guard position is pretty rare, and he uses them very well on defense.
And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. They won this game going away. They were the better basketball team by far tonight.
And you got to commend this sort of dominance, particularly here at home. It's a great feeling when you play almost a perfect game and to have that crowd be so pumped up.
And that about does it for the first game of the new NBA season. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew thanking you for tuning in. See you next time.